Hey guys, today we're going to be talking about battery drain when you're away from your car for an extended period of time, so if you're interested, stay tuned. So just for a little background, we just got back from a two-week vacation from Taiwan and Thailand, you know, just for fun, just to see the sights, and no, I did not get that illness. So don't worry about it, you're not going to get sick watching this video. So we were gone for a total of 13 days, and as you can see, I only lost 3% of my battery, or 8 miles total, and that averages out to about 0.2% per day. So also on another note, I'm probably the worst example for this type of thing, because I am fortunate to have a garage, and so the car was parked in the garage the whole 2 weeks, and I knew that the battery wasn't going to be fully, you know, drained or anything like that, so I didn't really worry about it at all. The only question I had was basically how much it was going to drain over those 2 weeks or a total of 13 days. But the point of this video is how to manage your battery, and I'm going to give you some tips on how to do that if you aren't as fortunate as me to have a garage or a charger in your garage. So since I knew the battery drain was going to be minimal since I have my garage, I didn't even bother plugging it in. Elon has mentioned that if you are going to be away for an extended amount of time, you should plug it in. So if you want to do that, you can, just for peace of mind. But like I said, I didn't really worry about it because I knew it was going to be fine. Elon did have a silly quote too. He said a plugged in Tesla is a happy Tesla. So basically, if you want to just avoid having to worry about battery drain at all, and you have the capability to plug it in from your garage, go ahead and do it and you don't have to worry about it at all. But for me personally, the reason I didn't plug it in, even though I do have a 240 NEMA 1450 in my garage, is because I get free charging at work, and so it was kind of pointless to plug it in because then I'd just be spending money that I don't need to spend because I could just charge it up at work the next day when I came back. Okay, so now for some tips. So I'm going to assume that you don't have a garage to park in, that you can't charge whenever you want, and that you basically have to park your car outside full time. If you can, park your car in a shady spot. Overheat protection is a great feature, but it does drain the battery. So obviously putting the car in the shade will help reduce using your overheat protection, and that way you save battery. So it's still kind of colder out, but it is getting to be spring, so it's going to be a little bit warmer, but you still shouldn't really have too much of an issue with overheat protection, you know, until it gets to summertime when we get into the 80s and 90s like every day, then the car is going to start roasting and then, you know, it's going to have to use overheat protection to protect the MCU. Now, if you're watching this video and it is summertime, I wouldn't recommend turning off overheat protection altogether, because if your MCU, your main computer, melts, you're going to be SOL and it's going to be a lot of money. So a happy medium between having full-on overheat protection with the AC on and not is to set it to turn just the fan on. That way it does keep the MCU cool, but it doesn't drain as much battery as having the full-on HVAC system on. And just an example of how much energy overheat protection uses, last summer when I was just parked in my normal office parking lot, in like an 8-hour day, I was getting drained about 10 miles a day. So it does use a lot to protect the MCU. So if you start doing some math, 13 days or 14 days, 2 weeks, times, you know, times about 10 miles in an 8-hour work day, you know, that's obviously going to be times three if it's a full day. That's going to be a lot of battery drain, and by 2 weeks, you might have a totally dead battery, so you do need to watch out for that and be careful. Sentry mode is also another battery killer. Sentry mode uses about 1 mile per hour, so obviously it's going to be 24 miles in a day, and so it also obviously depends on your situation. If you have to use sentry mode, then you have to use it, but what I would recommend is maybe you park your car at a friend's house or somewhere where it's safe. You know, going back to the friend's house, maybe park it there because they'll probably be, you know, I'm going to assume they're going to be home so they can take a peek at the car here and there and make sure that it's okay and safe. Try and do something like that to not use sentry mode. That way you can save that battery because it does run, you know, if you're gone, it's going to be running 24 hours a day, which is just going to eat up your battery really quick. When you're away, don't check the app every 2 seconds to see how the car is doing. So a lot of people don't know this, but when you do check the app, if your car is in a deep sleep and you check the app, it's going to wake up the car, which does use quite a bit of battery. So if you keep doing it over and over again, you're going to chew up a lot of battery doing that. So just, you know, leave the app alone. The car is going to be fine and don't worry about it. When we're on this vacation, I checked my app a whole lot of zero times. So basically, you know, for my situation, since I am fortunate, I do have a garage, You know, obviously I knew it was not going to be, nobody's going to be stealing it or anything like that. So there's no reason for me to check it. It'd just be wasting my battery. So I didn't bother. Another good way is sunshades. So believe it or not, these things actually do like get rid of the heat, and they keep the heat out of the car. So they do really help the car, you know, not go into overheat protection. That way it doesn't have to use energy to protect the MCU. So the sunshades I just mentioned are for the front window. They also do have sunshades for the roof and the back window. I would definitely recommend getting those as well, because obviously the sun is, you know, overhead, which is going to go straight into the car. So if you have sunshades for the top, same thing, it's going to, you know, reflect those rays and try and keep those out of the car. And the last way is to get window tints. So obviously a lot of tuners get window tints and they do look cool. So you're going to have to check your state local laws and see what cops do care and don't care, but I would definitely get the back three, the two passengers and the the rear window. And, you know, if your state allows, you might want to get the front two as well, and maybe even the front windshield if you can. A good ceramic tint is probably the best option to keep UV rays out. I'll let you do the research on that, but I do have a link in the description if you want to, you know, take on window tinting the car yourself. There's kits where you can actually do it yourself. So there's a link in the description for that if you want to do it that way. So with tints, there's all sorts of variation. There's the super dark 10% tint, or maybe you want something a little bit lighter at 50%. You know, it all depends on what you're looking for. And again, your state laws. So if the cops care, they're probably going to care if you have like a 10% tint on your front windows, because then they're not going to be able to see you. And that's when they're going to pull you over and give you a fix-it ticket to take those off so they can see you. So, you know, check your state local laws and see what they, you know, what the laws are. And then you can figure out what kind of, how dark the tint you want, you know, to get. So that's all the tips I have for you today to try and minimize battery drain if you're on a extended vacation or a business trip. Which one do you think is the most surprising? Let me know in the comments. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. And thanks for watching.